stance on immigration.
So you say to people who are here illegally today, you're not going to be able to work here. Ultimately, you got to go home, apply for permanent residency here or citizenship, but you must get at the back of the line because there are millions of people who are in line right now that want to come here legally. I want those to come here legally.
So will that cost him the Hispanic vote? It could even cost him the nomination itself. Mark Thiessen is a former speechwriter for President George W. Bush. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning, Mark.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing well. So here's one of the things that have Romney supporters worried in terms of the Hispanic vote. This Republican-leaning group, the Hispanic Leadership Fund, say they're so upset with Romney's stance on immigration that they might withhold an endorsement and, this is more important, curtail their plans, extensive plans for voter contact in all of those western states, Colorado, Nevada, New Mexico. How badly would that hurt him?
It would hurt him, but I don't think it's going to happen. Look, a couple of things. I think Mitt Romney's not going to have any trouble attracting Hispanic voters, particularly Republican-leaning Hispanic voters, for one reason. I'm going to predict to you today that he's going to pick Marco Rubio as his vice presidential candidate. Rubio helps in Florida. Rubio helps with the Tea Party, and he helps with Hispanics. I think a Romney-Rubio ticket is going to get a lot of Hispanic voters.
Now, hasn't,
but second,
well,
sorry,
hasn't guys. Rubio said he has no interest in such a thing?
I think if asked, he will serve his country. I would be very surprised if he turned it down, and I'd be very surprised if Romney didn't offer it. But second of all, he's not running in a vacuum. He's going to be running against Barack Obama. And, you know, Barack Obama's support among Hispanics has plummeted by 22% since he took office for all the same reasons that his support has plummeted in the rest of the country. If you're a Hispanic entrepreneur who's getting killed by Obamacare, by overregulation, by overtaxation, you're not going to vote for Barack Obama. If you're a Hispanic Catholic or evangelical who's concerned about the sanctity of marriage and the sanctity of human life, you're not going to vote for Barack Obama. So Hispanics aren't necessarily monolithic one-issue voters.
But look at this poll, this recent poll in a head-to-head matchup among the Hispanic voting bloc has President Obama 49%, Mitt Romney 28%. And maybe we should get away from Mitt Romney as the focal point of this, even though that was the point of this Washington Post piece. What about the GOP in general? The trouble with the Hispanic vote. Karl Rove has warned for a while that this is going to be their biggest problem.
Well, look, if Republicans don't win, Hispanics are the largest growing ethnic group in this country. If Republicans get in the 2020 election, if the Republican nominee gets the same percentage of the Hispanic and white votes that George Bush got in 2000, that John McCain got in 2008, the Republican is going to lose by 14 points. And Florida won't be a swing state. Texas will be. So it's very important that the Republicans are open to and welcoming to the Hispanic vote. But the way you do that is what Mitt Romney is doing, and you showed the clip of it. He always makes clear that he is a supporter of legal immigration. And I think the way you frame that is, look, we're the party of Ronald Reagan. We believe in the shining city on a hill. That city has walls because we have enemies that want to hurt us. But that city also has a gate that is wide open to anyone who wants to come here and build a better life. And so he needs to have that balanced message. Illegal immigration is, we have to oppose it because it's illegal. But we are also welcoming to illegal immigration.
Maybe you should be his speechwriter. That was a compelling argument there, Mark.
And, I'm out of that business.
And also a bold prediction about the Rubio vice president. We'll see what happens. Thanks so much, Mark.
We've got the videotape, Mark, so there's no going back now.
Right.
Excellent.
We will hold it against you.
Thanks, Mark.
All right, we know divorce rates are high, but new